Hey guys, welcome to Appalachia's Homestead. Tara here with a quick video for you out here in the barn. Hope the lighting is working out. It's mid-afternoon. It's a good time to make this video, but you know, lighting sometimes, you know, may not be optimal. But we wanted to film for you a quick video of our barn. We've had a lot of requests to see exactly what we've done. So I'm going to go through that real quick just to give you an idea of what it's like in here. We designed the barn ourselves. You can go buy plans. You can go to Lowe's and the library and see all types of different books on sheds and barns and different things like that. We did look at some of those. I had already an idea in my mind of what I wanted. The only thing I couldn't decide on was what color I wanted my barn to be. That was probably the biggest decision. We did go with classic red because it always came back to the red barn. So the outside is red if you haven't seen the pictures. The inside we decided to go with because of where we have it, which is relatively flat. Is a 24 by 30. I can tell you that if you're going to build a barn or a shed and you can possibly afford to go bigger than what you think you need, go bigger. Because we wish we had gone bigger. We've got plenty of space, don't get us wrong, but now that we're continuing to homestead and add and do, we're like, maybe we should have done 30 by 36, you know, something like that. So just want to go ahead and tell you that if you're planning to build a lean-to, a barn, a shed, a chicken coop, that whatever you have in your mind in terms of size that you think you need, go a little bit bigger, okay? Trust me on that. So it's 24 feet. So my husband is right now filming, and he's at the back side. So what you're seeing in terms of right back here is almost the same thing behind him, and we'll go through that. The main thing that I wanted in my barn, besides stalls and size, the basics, is I was very adamant in terms of having electricity and having water. I learned the hard way last year that we have a large, very nice, it's practically a mini barn in a sense, that we built, hand-built for the goats. And you had to, you know, there's no electricity down there. There was no water. And, you know, you can get by with all that, especially if you have few animals. Don't get me wrong on that. But I knew that we were going to be adding. I knew we were going to move the barn up close top, you know, of our property near the house and by our big garage. So, you know, adding electricity and water wasn't going to be that expensive. So if you're somewhere that you can do it and you can spring for that also, even if it's just an outlet and maybe a spigot, okay? I'm telling you, if you can pull those resources inside just a little bit, it is the biggest help on the planet, okay? So I just want you to think about that if you can change it or build or whatever. So when you walk into the barn, now I'm going to come around here. When you come into the barn, I wanted this side. This is coming from the farmhouse. We have our coop way over there. I wanted a side entry. Because I knew opening to come into the barn, I had my door shut. My doors would be shut a lot. And so I wanted to be able to come in with ease whenever I wanted. So I said the first stall here, I wanted to be our utility stall, as we call it. This is where our sink is. This is where we do our, you know, it's a little bit dirty in here. You have chickens flying in. You got some poop. It's constant cleaning. But I wanted my shelving, I wanted my feed, I wanted my remedies or medication, whatever my working, you know, stuff. I wanted to be in here. My, you know, turning on and off my light, whatever. This is the workroom, if you will. So we have a gate. I'm going to back up. We have a gate. And, of course, some of the chickens have, you know, figured out how to get around that. It's just part of what we live with. Oh, TMI going on down here. Don't. So if we turn back around this way, I don't want to jump in front of the camera. If you turn back right here, so basically this is six stalls, okay? First stall over there when you come in is the utility stall like you saw, it's working. And then we had six blank spaces, which I tell you in all of my videos, you know, it's kind of like a blank slate. We have it set up in a certain way right now, but everything can be moved. In a couple of hours, I could have my chickens nesting down there. I could move the cow in here. I don't want anything permanent because we are also quickly finding out that things very much quickly change in terms of animals and where you need them and what you want to do with them. You know, we have two kind of empty stalls in a sense, but we are utilizing them as a nursery and then the feeding stall, and then we have the goats, we have the cow, but we can always transform it, and we probably will when she delivers, gives us a fresh baby. preparation gives the fresh bed. Hopefully if that goes well, it may end up in its own stall. I don't know. We also milking, so we're still kind of thinking, are we going to milk her in here? So, and you may have these plans in your mind, and then when the time come, plans change. So, moral of the story is we like to keep things very fluid in terms of what's permanent. There is nothing permanent in here. So what we've done for now, if you've seen on one video, we made this the nesting stall. This is the girls. Now the boys come in here sometimes, like this bad boy right here, Luke Duke. He's our Americana rooster, one of. We have two. And this is where we have all the, this is where they give us most of our eggs. We had figured out very quickly that we had a couple of hens that love to go up in the loft. So we got smart and put a nesting box up there that we check once or twice a day. You can probably see it there. We've got hay up there. We're covering it with plastic. That's just part of our hay portion. We have a lot of it in the next door shed for ease. And we're continuing to buy some more this week. But we have one little nesting stall up there. And since we put that one nesting box up there, they don't lay their eggs anywhere but either. They're hitting all the nesting boxes now. So if you can't beat them, join them. Some of those girls have it in their mind. They like it up there. And so I said, let's try the nesting box. And I can go up there on any given evening, and I can have anywhere from 8 to 27 eggs. No joke. But it's not in the hay bales. It's not in the plastic. It's right there in that little nesting box. They really like it. So I think it's a little bit warmer right now up there. So basically, you're just seeing the setup. We have the gates. I wanted gates on every stall for obvious reasons. And I wanted electricity. Now, we designed the size of the barn so that we can drive a tractor through the middle from the front of the house or my husband's big truck. We can actually drive it. If push comes to shove, we open both doors, we open our gates. And obviously, if these weren't here, we can drive a vehicle through. We can have a vehicle driving through within a half an hour. So that was done on purpose. We wanted to be able to park. If we have a tractor, we want to park it or drive it, move something, we have that mobility. We wanted a full loft. That was for obviously storage purposes. The chickens like to get up there, so you do have to monitor that in terms of cleaning and scraping and whatever. Right now, it's not too big of an issue. I'm trying to keep them going outside. It's cold, so they like to come in. Obviously, you know about our new addition here. She is not spoiled at all. What you got there, baby? We are trying, as you know, we've had her now about, we got her before Thanksgiving, so we're pushing 2 months, and she's doing very well. We put our animals up when we leave. I do not leave my animals out when I'm not on the premises. So, we want them to have their own space and own stall and whatever. She's doing very well. So she has her own stall in here. She's filling out nicely. She needs a bath. We've talked about that before, but, hey. Down here for now, this is the goat stall. This is what they know, Mama and Bubba, and they are the biggest photobombing attention getters ever, aren't you? Oh, Mama.
Are you gonna look at the camera and talk to
them? So we keep them in there. For now, we keep this old thing in here. Every day I clean out the stalls, and I'm filling that up at least two times. Stop pulling my hair. We fill those up at least two times to take out to the garden. Now back here, obviously, we have the steps to go upstairs. This is what I'm gonna suggest to you. Watch out, boss hog. My husband came up with this. I didn't. He's such a genius. We have the doors, but we also have gates. And that may seem a little excessive, but let me tell you right now, it's wonderful because I can put the cow and the goats out, and I can shut this and just... What do you want? And leave a little bit of... gap here and lock it, and the chickens can come in and out with ease, and I can leave the rest of them out, and no one's eating each other's feed or food and hay and whatever. So this is a big plus. I would highly recommend you look into doors and gates also. So as I was saying, this was our back area, and so this is pretty much our barn. And yes, I did add a chandelier. theory was, we're putting a light. My husband was adamant about having a light up in the loft in case we need to work in the loft to have a little bit of light up there. And I thought, well, if we're going to spend money for, you know, a light, I love chandeliers. It's one of my things. So, hey. So that's why we have the chandelier. I just like it. So this is our barn. This is where we do a lot of our living these days and learning a lot. You can learn a lot in a barn. I can certainly attest to that, whether it's you or your children. So hope you enjoyed seeing this. And, you know, you're just enjoying what we do. Subscribe to us here on YouTube. Check us out on Facebook. Follow us there. Follow us on Instagram. And also on our blog. Somebody's trying to get some serious attention.
What do you want?
Y'all take care. We'll talk to you soon.